guys, we're back with another episode of Jimmy Makes Science Simple Short, and I have a brand new study I want to share briefly about from the abstract, and it was published in the journal Neurological Sciences. It was published on April 12, 2021. The title of the paper, The Effect of Ketogenic Diet on Thyroid Functions in Children with Drug-Resistant Epilepsy. So a lot of people think that going on a ketogenic diet lowers a thyroid function, so they wanted to look at these kids with epilepsy doing the ketogenic diet in a therapeutic sense. And keep in mind, that is a much higher fat version of keto than typical ketogenic diets, which tend to be around the 70 to 80% fat range. So let's see what the study found. Background. Ketogenic diet remains a valuable treatment option for children with drug-resistant epilepsy. However, it may cause many well-known adverse effects, such as dyslipidemia, which means high cholesterol, or kidney stones. But the effect on the thyroid function is largely unknown. Isn't it funny, though, that they go ahead and assume that if you go on a ketogenic diet, it's just going to mess with your thyroid? Nobody's investigated that. So they wanted to look at these kids, and the aim of the study was to investigate what impact the ketogenic diet had on thyroid function in those children who are doing a ketogenic diet for drug-resistant epilepsy. So what they did was they took a total of 66 children, 35 of them were female. They were between the ages of 3 and 193 months. And the average was 52 months. So these are very, very young children. All of them had drug-resistant epilepsy and who have received a ketogenic diet for at least 12 months before they enrolled in this study. So they wanted to make sure these kids have been doing a ketogenic diet for the purposes of controlling the seizures for at least 1 year. All children were started on the ketogenic diet with a 3-to-1 ratio, which was then adjusted as clinically necessary. So 3-to-1, if you're not familiar with this, the 3-to-1 ratio is 3 parts fat to 1 part combined protein and carbohydrate. That's a pretty heavy-duty ketogenic approach. So what they did, they measured free T4, which is the serum free thyroxine, and the TSH, which is thyroid stimulating hormone. These concentrations were measured before starting the treatment and at the first, sixth, and 12th months of treatment. They looked for changes in the free T4 as well as TSH concentrations over 12 months, and they analyzed those results. So what did they find? The median, which is the average, blood FT4, which is free T4, and TSH concentrations, and the frequencies of patients with low free T4 and high TSH concentrations did not change significantly in the study sample over the 12-month study period. In other words, all the conjecture about your thyroid slowing down and your thyroid getting damaged eating keto, it didn't happen. There was no change of what normally had been happening. Blood free T4 levels increased significantly and TSH concentrations decreased insignificantly in those 4 patients who were receiving a thyroid replacement therapy. So they were taking L-thyroxine replacement. So they were literally taking T4. They obviously had changes because they're taking a drug. But for the ones not taking a drug, the ketogenic diet really did not impact it negatively. So during the 12-month period, they saw the number of epileptic drugs or anti-epileptic drugs decrease significantly, which is not that uncommon when they're looking at ketogenic diets as a treatment for drug-resistant epilepsy. You would hope that the need for any drugs would go away. So in conclusion, it appears that the ketogenic diet therapy does not impair thyroid function in those children with drug-resistant epilepsy. The ketogenic diet can be used safely along with L-thyroxine replacement even in the children with a pre-existing subclinical hypothyroidism. Pretty fascinating study. Again, you guys, published in the journal Neurological Sciences, April 12, 2021. The title of the paper, The Effect of Ketogenic Diet on Thyroid Functions in Children with Drug-Resistant Epilepsy. Now, keep this in mind. The next time somebody says that the ketogenic diet is going to lower your thyroid function, according to this study, that is simply not true. Thanks so much for watching this episode of Jimmy Makes Science Simple Short, and we'll be back again real soon. Hey guys, you know I'm all about healthy nutrition, and I have a brand new product I want to tell you about called Athletic Greens. This is not just a multivitamin. It has 75 essential elements that you want to have in your diet, from probiotics to greens to digestive enzymes to prebiotics. There's so many things that they pack into the Athletic Greens. The main reason why I love them is it puts it all in one place. Like, literally, you'd have to a la carte by all of these different supplements, and they do it all in one package. So if you go to athleticgreens.com/Jimmy, and you can get a special discount if you go there, and the discount is you get a free 1-year supply of their vitamin D as well as some of their travel packs. Go check it out, you guys, athleticgreens.com/Jimmy.